Hey, what's up, guys? I'm going to show you how to cook a paella dish. We're rock on today. This meal comes from Spain. Hopefully this will work, jinx, touch wood. The kettle's going to be boiling for the rice and the veg. I'm putting sprouts, cauliflower and broccoli in this. Alright, let's check what we need to get out the fridge. Right then. I've got some garlic. I've got getting an onion out. An onion. Some rice. I've got Trezzo. And let me see what else I've got. Prawns. I've got the chicken. Oh, I need to get a frying pan. I'm going to do in the meantime is love it landscape. Chopping board needs to go landscape. Right, what I'm going to do is prep my onion. Now I'm going to cut the chicken first. That's what I was actually about to do. Can't find where I slit it now. Oh, here it is. Here's your chicken. You want to get that into small chunks. You want your chicken nice and small. And we'll put it into the frying pan to let it fry. If I can get that to kettle to hurry up. This is Espanol. Spain. This is from a Spain dish. Spanish dish. Espanol. I love Spanish food. Really, really delicious. That's all my chicken cut. I'm actually going to cut the breast because I'm saving half of this. Spanish rice dish. Spanish reminds me of Mexico, to be fair with you. This is Spanish food. It's actually from Spain. It's a good, delicious dish. Watch
fucking love it. Time enjoy it. From Spaniel. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. Keep that. Yep, keep the. Let the chicken get cut, cut, and cut. This is my chicken cut. I'm gonna let that sizzle while I cut the onions and the shrimp side. Always wash your hands while it's touching raw meat. Right, that kettle's done. I can put my rice in. Also my veg. Oh my god, where's that light on? I'm gonna turn it off so I don't gas the house. Oh, here it is. Saucepan for the lighting. There we go. For the rice. And for the, that was the veg, sorry, that's one for the rice. And let that boil. And now I am going. I'm going to have a bit of a dilemma here. Right, first of all, I will cut my onion. Right, I'll push that to the side. I'll push that to the side. Scrape the chicken bits off the knife. If you get more chicken in there, I'm gonna cut my onion up. Do you know I might give that room to cut my tripso? We're having a Spanish dinner today. And I love Spanish. Can I put my rice into there? Don't know what's making it bubble, but I'm going to make sure it's not actually washing up liquid going into there. So I will be in the S-H-I-T. Doesn't taste of it. I use too much salt for my rice, that's what it is, and that's the salt that I use. There we go. There we go, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right then. So let that boil well. I will put my veg in now. Put a couple of broccolis in and a couple of cauliflowers. That might be enough of the broccoli. And 3 cauliflowers in. That'll do. Right, my sprout thing.
Love it. Love paella. Now
this. Oh, I've got the rest in.
Put some salt in. Right, here we go. I am actually going to turn on the gas. Put a small bit of oil in. Some fry that actually. Right, the salt. Right.
Right, first I am going to cut the tripso. Quite nice. Cut the ends off. This is a Spanish sausage, which I'm going to cut right here. Tripso.
Lovely and Spanish. Love it.
Yeah, just cut your trips out. Make it into a lovely jubbly slices. Imagine you're cooking this for other people.
One more chunk.
Then I will show you the next bit.
This is from love. I just love tripso a lot, especially when you're cooking stuff into it. I'll cut it in half. I'll turn the rice down a little bit. Right, here we go. I'm going to rotate the chopping board. I am going to show that the frying pan show. Turn it on. There we go. Put my spotlight in. For a minute, I'll try to test it with an eye. We go, and we'll add the chicken in. go. In. Now I'm going to stir it. And that rice looks done to me. Let me go check. Now I'm going to boil it up more. Keep stirring, let it sizzle, and what you want is a nice paella. You normally put peas in it, but I don't like peas, so I'm going to add sprouts, cauliflower and broccoli. I also like carrots in it, because I couldn't find it with all three, with the broccoli, cauliflower and carrots. It just came in with cauliflower and broccoli. And sprouts always come in a separate pack normally. So if I had the carrots, it would have been all four veg. Let's see if this is cooked.
It is cooked. Well, you need to just mix that in. Oh god.
I have our prawns in now.
Here's my lovely, lovely prawns. Add them and mix it all up. Oh, it will be wonderful. Pie.
Hello.
I love paella so much. Eat it to the brim. And we're going to be simple how I eat. I'll let that to simmer. I'm going to add the rice in, but preferably you normally drain it. But I'm going to do this because there's not much water in there. Still cooked it though. Put a whole portion of that in. Mix that in carefully. People in Spain used to have this, I think, on the internet. I can't remember. For Christmas. Around Christmas as well. I think it's a week before Christmas, on the 18th of December. But we don't know. That's what I can't remember who apparently has said. Mix the paella in. Right, all jumbled. Turn that on. Now I'm going to face that in the way now, because it's... The rice is in there. Yeah, this is simply how you do a paella. Now, yeah, again, I've got to boil up the kettle. So I've got a mix of stock in. Now I'm going to check my veg. See if that's cooked there. Getting good. Turn it off. Turn up a little. Drain that, whatnot. Pull that in carefully. Here we go, the veggies in, now you've got to crush them. Before I put my oxo in, crush. Crush that broccoli, crush the, careful I don't get any. Crush the cauliflower. Yeah, just crush and crush and crush your life away and you'll get good at it. Now what I want to do,
put a bit of garlic in, which I forgot to do about 15 minutes ago.
15 minutes ago, props. Yeah, I forgot to put the garlic in. Now I can mix this in. Turn that down. Stir that all together. Let that cook. Now what you want to do,
I'm going to put my ox in. Put two in.
Just to grind it all in. Mash that in. Stir it round. Into a lovely mix. Do it carefully and carefully. Now I'm going to
add some water.
And put another ox in to mix it in, to brown it a little
so it meets.
I'm gonna melt it in. Pour that in and stir it clear. Let that simmer now for a minute. This is your Spanish dish. I don't want that any more overflowing. It's a bit hard when you're making a rice dish, to be fair. try and let the water soak into the rice and then it should be done. Let that soak in. Doing, and this bit's going to be doing as well. Pretty much when all that water soaked in. To get a fork to smash my sprouts up. Maybe not. Don't make soak sink that in. Have a look at what I'm doing.